Previously on Persona 5.
Ooh, we can do this! We can do this! Do this! Do this!
And now, back to Japanese high school. Heyo! Welcome back to Vero Plays Persona 5. So, tomorrow is the art exhibit, so let's go to bed and be.
Hey!
We're going to the exhibition tomorrow, right? Don't oversleep. Ichi Ryusai's Madarame, an infinite fund of ideas, huh? I read the blurb on the ticket, but it seems that this Madarame is actually an amazing artist. Some of his pieces, whoa, might be worth looking at after all. Alright. Let's go be a, you know, be an art appreciator. I realize that the percentage just keeps going down. Lame. Admin has to be trolling, man. What is this line for? Oh, that exhibition must be opening today. It's really packed. Wanna come back another time? I want it, but it's so expensive. Maybe I should take a loan. I wanna see that. Let's go together sometime. What?
It'll be a pain in the ass if someone sees you, so don't stick your head out too much, alright?
Oh, right. Pets not allowed.
You came!
Yeah.
You really came.
What'd you expect when you left us those tickets?
the reactions were so different.
Make sure that you don't get in the way of the other visitors.
Come now. I'll show you around.
I'd like to speak more about the picture I'd like to draw, too.
Well, see you guys later.
Bye. Have fun.
Will Lady Han be alright? What if he drags her behind some painting and tries something funny?
Then he'll just go to jail.
I told you not to come out! Are we really gonna appreciate the fine arts? Can't we just go home?
Let's learn more about Madarame while we still can.
I guess we should do a quick pass through at once. Which way are we supposed to start?
Follow me. Oh yeah, That's the guy, huh?
It's that old man from the other day.
We continue to be truly surprised by your imagination. You have such expansive styles. It's hard to believe that it all stems from one person. Where in the world does all your inspiration come from?
Well, it is rather difficult to put into words. They naturally well up from within my heart, like bubbles rising one after another in a spring.
Naturally, you say?
Bullshit.
What's important is to distance oneself from worldly desires, such as money and fame.
Bullshit. You have a bigger palace than anyone here.
My atelier is a modest shack, but it is more than enough to pursue true beauty.
A shack?
I see. So the act of emptying one's mind gives rise to inner beauty. Still, to think we could hear the word shack coming from the great artist Madarame.
You would understand if you saw it.
Shut up.
Wasn't the word shack something?
Madarame-san is actually here?
Over there!
I'm so glad I came on opening day!
Holy fucking shit!
Hey, stop pushing! There's way too many people!
I'm getting crushed!
Anyways, we gotta head for the exit! Don't die on us, alright?
I didn't know there were so many types of Japanese art!
Jeez Louise, man.
Usually, one concentrates on their own style. However, Sensei creates all this by himself.
Sensei, huh? What are you, a teddy? Who the hell uses Sensei in this day and age?
He's special.
There you are, Yusuke.
Sensei!
Ah, the girl from yesterday. Are you enjoying the exhibit?
I don't know how to put it into words. But it's really amazing.
I just realized something. An is like the only person who always get into these type of troubles with the, you know, with the big boys, the ones with palaces.
You're sensing something from the artwork. That alone is enough to give us artists satisfaction. I hope this becomes a wonderful piece, Yusuke.
I mean, An had a hell lot of trouble with... What was his name? Wow, I forgot that guy's name already.
Well then, if you'll excuse me...
It's the first guy. Wow, I can't even remember his name. Wow, I'm so sorry.
You'd imagine artists would be difficult to approach. But he seems really friendly.
Indeed.
Oh, this is it! The painting I wanted to see in person.
This one?
I guess it's the painter's anger? I'm not sure, but I sense this strong frustration from it. To think such a cheerful and gentlemanly person could make such a piece. Something wrong?
Don't mind me. There are better pieces than this one. Come now, this way.
Hey!
But I like this one, asshole. Oh yeah, his name is Kamoshida. Wow.
Ah, that old lady totally elbowed me.
I can't believe I forgot his name after a few days. Whoops.
Thanks to that, I remember now.
Oh, he remembers too. But what?
Well, let me get to it. It's about a post online. Here, look at this.
Why'd you leave without me?
You got it all wrong. We got dragged into this huge crowd and... anyways, you gotta look at this too. This post might be about Madarame.
What's it say?
A master of the Japanese arts is plagiarizing his pupil's work. Only his public face is shown on TV.
Huh?
Plagiarizing?
Plagiarizing.
I didn't think much of it when I first saw it, but hearing Shaq and Madarame triggered it.
What do you mean he's, like, using other people's work for himself?
His treatment of the pupils who live with him is awful. He teaches nothing and bosses them around. He treats them inhumanely, as if disciplining a dog.
So what's the point being under him if you're not gonna learn anything?
Abuse on top of plagiarism, huh?
If this is real, it'll be a huge scandal.
I wonder if Kitagawa-kun posted this. I mean, he is a pupil of his.
Who knows? It's anonymous and all.
In that case, it's possible the Madarame we heard about in Mementos is referring to the same one.
Huh.
A man like that doing such a thing? I wonder if we can ask that shadow from earlier about this. Oh, actually, we just need to talk to him in reality.
And how are we gonna go about that? Are we gonna explain it all, starting with Mementos?
Besides, if we make a move out in the open, there's the possibility that Madarame will find out.
Oh, yeah, right.
Hey, what do you think about Madarame? Doesn't he seem suspicious?
Well, you know, I mean, I already know what's gonna happen, so...
I know, right? This all fits way too well to just be a coincidence. If this post is legit, ain't this the kind of target we've been waiting for?
Well, yeah, but... is it really true?
By the way, what did you do about the whole modeling thing?
Kitagawa-kun gave me his contact info. And the address to his sensei's atelier.
He said he lives there, right? Perfect timing.
Good call.
Let's try going tomorrow. We're off to Madarame's house right after school.
Or we can just check his palace, maybe?
Huh? You want me to model tomorrow? This is too sudden.
What? We're just gonna go talk to Kitagawa.
Oh, that's what you meant.
No, right. Okay, so I guess we're gonna go to his house? Weird.
Okay,
In any case, we need to find out if that rumor about Madarame is true. If it is, this might just be exactly what we needed. What did everyone do today? They slept.
Wow!
What a huge cardboard box! Is there nothing we can do today?
Nice!
Hey everyone, it's time to do some shopping. 4 bags of protein. Drink this and you'll be muscle-bound in no time. That's fucking expensive, man. Well, I have a lot of money, so whatever. Still, I think that's kinda expensive.
Hey!
Our investigation on Madarame starts tomorrow, you know? Let's call it a day and go to sleep.
Well then.
This is Ephemerality's first target. Let's be careful and make sure we do things right. Alright. Just go to fucking bed then. Huh. It's going up and down the whole fan site approval poll thing.
Oh yes.
The great artist Madarame is holding an exhibition in Shibuya right now, isn't he? I've gone to see his works a number of times. Goodness, are they magnificent. The moment I saw them, I knew he was something else. By the way, you seem far removed from the art, Xiaoku. What do you mean by that?
Here's a question.
Do you know who created the piece which sold for the highest price back in the 20th century? Madarame. Van Gogh. Because I'm cheating.
Oh, not bad.
That's correct. It seems you know a thing or two after all. That piece was purchased for the equivalent of 18 billion yen, and it sold for even more later. However, since the turn of the 21st century, a new record has been set practically every year. Hey, did you know that? I had no idea. Maybe he actually is smart. Oh shoot, the teacher's glaring at us.
Nice going!
Huh, you keep calling me smart, but... Let me guess, this point is gonna make me rank up, right?
Alright.
No? Oh. People put a serious amount of passion and money into art. If I had that kind of money, I wouldn't mind having a painting or two myself. Seems like art can make you a tidy sum. Let's see with our own eyes whether or not the accusations of him stealing art are true. You're meeting Lady Anne and the others at the train station, right? Let's go when class lets out. Huh.
Come on.
Phantom Thieves going by train. This ain't any different from how I get home from school, you know. The train is the fastest way to go, plus we can bring pets on here.
No!
Hey, who are you calling a pet? Do be quiet, we didn't pay the pet fare. I'm the one guiding you to your destination, you should be calling me master.
Hey!
Ooh, kitty! Shoot. Is that your pet, mister? I heard it meowing. It's a stuffed animal. Yeah, it's just a toy, it meows when you press on its head.
Hey!
You heard her, Vero. Press on its head. This is ridiculous. Wowee, again. Time to button mash. What the fuck, man? Holy shit, you went wild on that. I bet he's dead now. Oh god. That's so funny, I want to hear it again. I just threw up in my mouth. Seriously? The next stop is Shibuya. Shibuya. Doors will open on the left side. Oh, this is our stop. We'll see you later. Bye-bye. Bye. I am so sorry, Morgana. I didn't expect him to go wild, man.
Yeah!
So, which line do we gotta transfer to? Doesn't look like there are any stations close by to that address. If anything, this is the closest station.
For real?
But then we gotta walk the rest of the way? What kind of Phantom Thief takes this train and then walks to their destination? Stop your complaining. It's supposedly a shack but lives in the neighborhood he lives in is expected of a famous artist.
Okay, let's get going.
Looks like the fastest route is to get to Station Square and then go to Central Street. Let's go. Let's move. You can't get to Central Street this way. Oh. Well, I don't know where to go again, as usual. I hear you want to see Mr. Madarame's exhibit. May I ask your talk? Oh, it was amazing. Every piece on display was absolutely superb. Mr. Madarame truly is the pride of Japan's artwork. Already a huge success, extremely hard to come by. Right. I wish I could paint again. It's his fault I have to live such a shitty life. Who do you mean? Got nothing to do with you. He's fooled everyone. You're all idiots. Aww, that's sad. Alright, I guess I should get to Central Street or whatever.
Wait.
It's supposed to be in the residential area past Central Street. We'll have to walk a bit though, so let's get going. Right.
Suguru Kamoshida, former Olympian, teacher at Shujin Academy. Reason for turning himself in is a heavy conscience, huh? The human mind doesn't change that easily, let alone their natural temperament. Shujin Academy. Seems doubtful. Perhaps I'll have someone look into it, just in case.
I'm beginning to realize something. Maybe this guy is the cause of the psychotic breakdowns in some way, or at least he knows the cause of it. Because in a way, psychotic breakdowns are kind of the same as changing
is
their heart.
Is that it?
Holy shit, your house looks like a shithole.
We're at the right address. The door plate does say Madarame.
You ring the bell.
Me? The walls won't collapse when I do, will they? No one sneeze or we'll blow this house down, okay?
Bing bong a ling along.
Who is it? Sensei is currently...
it's Takamaki.
I'll be right out.
People really do live here.
Takamaki-san.
You two are here as well?
Hey, stop that condescending look.
Hey, sorry, but we ain't here to talk about the modeling thing. There's something we gotta ask you. Is it true Madarame's plagiarizing stuff? He's abusing people too, yeah?
Are you serious?
We read about it online.
This? Preposterous! Not only is the plagiarism impossible, but abuse? If he hated children so much to harm them, he would never allow pupils into his home. And I'm the one residing here and studying under him. I'm saying it's not true, so it's beyond doubt.
You might be lying about it.
That is utter rubbish. I had no family when Sensei took me in and raised me into what you see now.
Yeah, maybe, you know, that whole Madarame guy is keeping the truth away from him.
If you continue to ridicule the man I owe my life to, you will rue this day!
Yeah, I think he's keeping it under the ropes.
You really think that?
Yusuke, what's the matter? I heard you yelling.
These people are slandering you with baseless rumors.
Well, we're screwed.
Forgive them, Yusuke. They must have heard some bad rumors and came in worry for their friend's safety.
Understood, Sensei.
Well, even I doubt that a cranky old man like myself could be liked by everyone.
That's not what we meant.
I'm sorry to have butt in on your conversation. However, I do have neighbors around. Won't you please keep it down? Now, if you'll excuse me.
That was discourteous of me. I'm sorry. I know. I think you'll be able to believe in Sensei if you saw that painting. It's his maiden work, as well as his most representative piece. It's titled Sayuri.
Sayuri?
This was the painting that inspired me to become an artist.
It's so beautiful.
Well, I was never an art guy, so...
I don't know all this fine art stuff, but even I can tell that this is impressive.
It is? Well, whoops.
When I first saw you, I felt the same powerful emotion as when I saw this painting.
Please, marry me and make babies.
Me?
I wish to pursue beauty like this. And I believe drawing you will be part of that pursuit. I implore you, seriously consider my offer.
And also accept this ring that I bought.
I'm sorry that you took the time to come all this way, but I must assist Sensei today. I hope that we can discuss this further another time. If you'll excuse me then.
Those two seem like nice guys, don't they?
Maybe the Madarame we heard about in Mementos is a different person.
Man, right when we thought we found a new target, too.
How's the Metanav?
Oh.
Hey, the app!
Was it picking up our conversation? This display... It means that Madarame has a palace too, right? But why?
Madarame, plagiarism, and then Shaq, huh? These seem to be the keywords.
For real though, what the hell's going on? Does an old man like him really have a palace?
We have the person's name and the location. All that's left is the what that Madarame mistakes the shack for to enter his palace.
Huh.
You mean like how Kamoshida thought the school was his castle?
That's right. Let's try saying some things. They can be random guesses.
It's a bit sudden though.
I see.
Why don't we start with castle?
Then what about prison?
No candidates found.
Ugh, what a pain!
It's kind of funny how I keep shaking my head.
Jail, warehouse, and guidance counseling office. Might as well add farm.
No candidates found.
A single hit?
Should we come back another time?
A building that's related to artists. If we think from there, what would it be?
Huh. Art school, an art supply store, or a museum.
Beginning navigation? Whoa, really?
So it is a museum. Well, here we go. Time to kick ass again. Hey, when did you activate the NAV? You surprised me. Didn't have much of a choice, I think we just happened to get it right. What if I hadn't noticed and then wandered off and get caught by an enemy?
Come on!
You probably would have figured it out once you started walking on two legs.
Hey!
So even you can slip into the metaverse without realizing it, Morgana? Yep, in a place with minimal cognitive distortion, the difference can be subtle.
What?
Forget that, look. That shack is seriously some kind of museum?
Hey!
Let's go check it out. Oh, there's a lot of people here.
It's so extravagant, to the point that it's gaudy. It's a museum, right?
This is Madarame's?
A palace is a scenery driven by desires. Just like how Kamoshida's palace was a castle.
Madarame's artwork is on display at museums in reality too, though. His exhibit was popular, and people already respect him. Why would he fantasize about a museum?
Beats me.
You got a point. It ain't related to plagiarism or abuse either.
Let's try looking around. Racking our brains here won't do us any good.
Right. That aside, ain't a museum a must for phantom thieves?
Definitely. Oh, there are probably traps
now
too.
That's our Joker. I feel the same.
But man, just look at that insane crowd.
Alrighty, righty, right. What are we gonna do today?
Yes!
Well then, it's time to begin our infiltration. Are we gonna have to wait in that gigantic line? Don't be stupid, we're not going in the front door. Well, there's a high wall around the building. We'll just have to find our way up over it then. In any case, let's get going. Check on the Madarame rumors and infiltrate the museum, huh? Cool. Before that, I want to see if there's any...
I can feel it.
Any interesting... Oh, no, nothing of interest. Let's just get going.
Yep.
This is really how he thinks of that rundown shack. It's overwhelmingly shiny. It's just not hitting me that this is that old guy's palace. That's why we're here, right? Come on, let's go check it out. Alright. Oh man, this is cool. I like the aesthetics. The designs are really pretty. Makes me feel like I'm in a real area, you know? Like a real museum. A life stone, huh? Why do I see red dots? Whatever.
Hey!
Ooh, the skylight's open. I think we can get in here. But it's a pretty far drop. Will we be able to get back out this way? Don't worry. Have a rope. I'm our tool specialist. Specialist, after all. So what's your call, Joker? Let's do this. Alright, we're inside the museum.
How suspicious.
It's quiet. Almost too quiet. Hey, this... It's moving. Come on, we're in the palace. There ain't anything to be freaking out over. The palace reflects its ruler's heart. We may want to check these paintings out.
Hmm?
Oh hey, there's some kind of explanation here. Let me see. It's someone's name and age. What the hell? That can't be the title of the painting, right? Do you think it's the artist's name? Let's check the other paintings too. I think there might be something important about them. Oh, right. Hey, this guy looks familiar. So what's with all these paintings? What do you want me to do? It's all the same, really. I can't read that. Oh, this one is pretty big. Hmm. Well, I guess I'll go to the...
Hey!
This doesn't make any sense. Madarame is famous for having a variety of art styles, but all the portraits on the display here looks the same. This is way different from what was at a... Wait a sec. Yeah, that's the guy,
damn
huh?
It.
Ain't this that guy we saw in Mementos? You know, the one who was shit-talking Madarame? Natsuhiko Nakanohara. His name's written on the plate. Dude, I don't get it. Why is there a painting of him in here? And more important, why is his name written under it? You're right, doesn't art usually have like, the title of the piece or the artist's name? This is quite the mystery. Alright, let's keep looking around for now. Okay. Why the hell? Stop. Seriously. You gotta chill the fuck out. There's no enemies yet. This place is really cool though. What? No way. Oh yeah, hey, it's that dude.
Hey.
Hey, isn't this a painting of that guy? It says Yosuke Kitagawa. There's no mistaking it.
Huh?
Wait a second. What do you think these paintings are? Madarame's pupils, I suppose? I think you're right.
What?
For real, all of them? But it was only Yosuke when we went to his place before. This must include former pupils as well. Only one remains now. Taking into account what that Nakanohara guy said earlier, things are getting clearer. Alright, we need to keep investigating. We need something to further confirm our deductions. Huh. This is a mystery. What does that tell us about his cognition? Well, obviously he's fucking insane. Hey,
wait.
Shouldn't we avoid touching stuff we don't need to? Right. Holy crap, I feel like I'm in a puzzle game. There seems to be kind of a pamphlet. What's up, you find something? We're here to investigate, so we should check everything that catches our attention.
Thank you for choosing to visit us.
Treasure chest spotted! Let's open it!
I don't have lockpicks though. Is this a pamphlet? This is getting way too detailed for a freaking palace. Why'd he bother making something like this? There is a museum guide on here. Let's take it with us. It might even show us the location of the treasure.
Nice.
That is a possibility. At the very least, it should be a good reference for the scale of this place. Oh, but the map only shows half of the museum, as usual. And the 2 out of 2's gotta be around here somewhere, right? Just how big is this place? We can worry about that another time. Right now, our objective is looking into Madarame's cognition. We may have to reconsider our plan depending on what we find. I mean, he's got a palace. Seems pretty fishy to me.
Joker! A treasure!
Oh!
Well, look, I would really love to make lockpicks, but each time I make lockpicks, I waste an evening, so... That's cool. Very realistic. Torchbearer my ass. Oh, cool. Wow.
Look at this. The Infinite Spring? A conglomerate work of art that the great director Madarame created with his own funds. These individuals must offer their ideas to the director for the rest of their lives. Those who cannot do so have no worth living?
Hey, this is most likely about the plagiarism, right?
Damn it, what a phony geezer!
In other words, his pupils are his property. He doesn't even qualify as an artist if this is true. He's stealing the ideas from talented students in exchange for securing their livelihood. I wondered about those portraits on display. They must all be his pupils through his cognition. This even says that they have no worth. Couldn't this be about the abuse? Madarame will keep them around as long as they're useful to him. But the moment they're not...
Off to the trash heap.
He's treating them like slaves or tools!
Why is Yusuke keeping quiet about this? He's got no reason to cover this up!
Well, he's dumb, so he doesn't know anything about this, probably.
He did say that he owes Madarame his life for being taken in.
But still!
When we were at the exhibit, I praised one of the pieces on display. But Kitagawa-kun acted strange. Maybe that piece was plagiarized too.
What's the call? Ain't this enough to target Madarame?
what you offer.
We should confirm these facts with Yusuke first.
Yeah.
Confirm what, though?
It means we should get solid evidence that such crimes actually took place.
What a pain in the ass.
Besides, there's too much we don't know about Madarame yet.
You're right. I'll try contacting Kitagawa-kun. I might be able to get the truth out of him if I accept his modeling offer.
Wait, you're gonna do that?
You all better come with me, okay? I'm scared to go alone.
Famous, renowned artist, huh? Wow, this might be tougher than Kamoshida. Well, we'll just prep ourselves until we get confirmation from Yusuke. This is our first mission as real Phantom Thieves. We're gonna succeed no matter what.
All right. The reason why Yusuke is hiding the truth, huh? Would you really forgive someone unconditionally if you owe your life to them? I'm not so sure anymore. What are you bringing this up for? According to Kitagawa-kun, Madarame isn't a problem. What do you mean? Something wrong? I mean, I know Madarame is a bad person, but still. Maybe I'm so hesitant because I haven't actually met any of his victims. Yeah, I guess that's part totally different from what happened with Kamoshida. This might be an extreme line of thinking. But if an evil person isn't causing any trouble now, is there really a point in us stepping in? Well, you got a point. So we're gonna let Yusuke decide if Madarame is worth going after or not? I don't know, if it were me, I'd never forgive that bastard. Well, let's see how Yusuke feels. Yeah, I guess we could talk some more after that. Okay, let's meet in Shibuya after school tomorrow. Let me guess, slept.
Okay.
Our only choice now is to ask Yusuke about this. Your fingerprints were on the murder weapon.
That's undeniable proof that you did it. Give it up. Objection.
Huh, he figured out pretty fast.
Nice.
Alright, let's go to bed. Let's call it a day, go to bed, and then continue with our investigation in the morning.
Yo.
Hey, it's me. I just can't forgive Madarame, but what An said made me think. To Yusuke, are we just a bunch of thugs? Probably. I knew it.
I'm gonna make him pay.
It ain't like he thinks it is. Pisses me off just thinking about it. Good people have to put up with so much crap while shitty adults do whatever they want. Makes me sick. I'm not wrong, am I? We'll take them down.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Don't tell An I called you, by the way. Seriously.
See ya.
No, see you tomorrow. I'm a shapeshifter. Post a masquerade. Oh, get the fuck out with this shit. Lol. Wow. These people online aren't very nice. Alright, I contacted Kitagawa-kun about modeling for him. Still waiting for his response. Max, I really have no idea what I'm supposed to do as an art model, though. Just be yourself. That's actually kinda hard. Look, you don't gotta go all out for this. You're only doing it so you can get dirt on Madarame, remember? That is true.
Whoops.
Sorry. It sounded like Kitagawa-kun wants this to be a private picture of his, though. Well, I guess I'll let you guys know when he contacts me again.
Hey!
I got a response from him. He said he wants to come over after school today. Perfect, he probably changed his plans immediately just so he could get you over there. We need to find out what Kitagawa-kun if what we saw in the palace was true. Okay, quiet down, it's that student council president.
Come on, man.
Yikes, she got hold of Mishima today. It'd suck if she'd notice us. Come on, let's split up. Okay, see you later. We finally landed a big target. Come on, let's get some dirt on Madarame. But man, honestly.
Sorry.
I was thinking about some things and didn't notice how much time had passed. Thinking about what?
okay.
Don't you think Kitagawa-kun has to be protecting Madarame? I mean, they live together, so he'd have to be aware of Madarame's true nature. The only reason I can think for him doing that is that Madarame has something on him. Yeah, that's weird.
Wait!
But that's why we're going to check it out, right? You ready to be a model? Yeah, I'm prepared. What do you mean prepared? Prepared for what?
Hey!
Something seemed different about her. Wait, something seemed different about her to you? Well, did she cut her bangs?
Whoa!
Ooh, nice eye. I didn't cut them. well, let's get going. We gotta talk to Yusuke. Kitagawa-kun seemed really happy when I agreed to be his model.
Okay.
Once he finishes drawing and gets a little friendlier, we should bring up Madarame. Okay. Whatever floats your boat.
I thought it would just be you coming, Takamaki-san.
Actually, to be honest, I wouldn't feel very comfortable like trying to paint while these guys are around me.
Wouldn't you get nervous too if it was just the two of us?
No.
We're here to keep an eye on you, so don't try anything perverted, okay?
Stop making such odd assumptions. I have absolutely no interest in her as someone of the opposite sex.
Huh?
Oh, damn.
Is there a problem?
No, not really.
Well then, let's get started.
All right.
Hey. Kitagawa-kun?
You hear her?
He's concentrating. Don't you know how an artist works?
It's no use. This isn't what we planned. We were gonna catch him off guard and make him spill his beans, weren't we?
How are we supposed to know this was gonna happen? Guess we just gotta wait till he's done. What an effing pain in the ass.
Perhaps I should try going outside this room.
Well, don't get caught, I guess.
Who do you think you're talking to? This is too boring, so I'm going to scout around a bit.
You better not be dead when I'm back. It's weird how flashy that door is. And is that a lock? A door with a hefty lock. What could be in there, I wonder?
Huh. Are you done?
Well, that's what I expected. I knew he wouldn't, you know.
It's no good.
What?
I'm sorry. Am I the problem?
No, not at all. It's just... I'm having trouble staying focused today. I'm sorry, but we'll have to resume this another time.
Oh, hell no! How many hours do you think you made us wait?
Hours? Jesus fucking Christ.
I'm sorry. We had another reason for seeing you today. We needed to talk to you.
It's about those rumors regarding your sensei.
Oh, not again. Jesus Christ, Ryuji, don't you know how to talk to people?
This again.
That painting I saw at the exhibit. You're the one who actually painted it, right?
That's...
I knew it.
Your sensei seriously messed up. He just thinks of his pupils as tools. That's why he doesn't give a damn whether he steals their work or physically beats them. I'll make this clear. There's no point in hiding stuff from us.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
You couldn't go against him, could you? I'm sure we can help you out, though.
Stop it. It's just as you all say. We're our sensei's artwork. Don't misunderstand me, though. I offered my ideas to him myself. As such, it can't be called plagiarism. Sensei is simply suffering from artist's block right now.
Dude, still!
Kitagawa-kun.
Then why are you sticking around? All his other pupils ran away. Aren't you the only one left?
What's wrong with a pupil helping out his master? There are no victims here.
Stop pushing your self-centered righteousness on me.
But he's stealing. And the other pupils?
I'm supporting Sensei as his pupil. Where's the wrong in that? Don't ever come here again. If you do, I'll sue you for causing a disturbance.
Hold it! We're not done talking here!
Then you leave me with no choice.
Hey!
Oh shit, he's calling the cops.
I'm reporting you to the police. I asked Hakamaki-san to be my model today, but I don't recall ever calling you two here.
What the F, man?
Yuji, stop it! Calm down, okay?
Damn it!
I won't report you, but only under one condition.
What's that?
I want you to continue being my model, Takamaki-san.
Oh shit, the tables have turned.
But you said that it wasn't working out today.
That's because I was unconsciously being modest for your sake. However, I have nothing to worry about anymore. If you're willing to bear everything to me...
Wait, what?
I will put my heart and soul into creating the best nude painting ever!
Wait, what?
What?!
Nude?!
Nude!
To think I'd be able to create a nude painting with my most ideal model! Of course, you two won't be allowed in, and I ask that you forget about our discussion today as well. If I don't submit a new piece to Sensei soon, there will be some... inconveniences.
Nude? Meaning it'll be without any clothes, right? Why are things suddenly escalating like that?
Damn, this guy's guts is off the hook. I bet this guy's guts is like rank 4, while I'm only at rank 2.
Because those are my terms.
But that's... Wait, ain't that bad?
Sensei is out during the afternoon while the art exhibit is on, so I can use this place freely.
Sneaky.
I should buy more art supplies.
Will you give me a second here?
Of course. I'm willing to wait. I'll make time according to your plans, but please come before the exhibit ends.
No, that's not what I mean! Why are you not listening?
Sensei will be returning home soon. We're done for today. Takamaki-san, I'll be waiting for you to contact me.
No! We are not done talking here!
Hey, what should we do?
I don't know, man. What the fuck?
Yeah, damn it. He got us good this time.
Don't give up so easily!
See you later. Have fun getting nude.
Is she done being a model?
A cat?
You moron!
Have fun being a model, Takamaki. Takakakamaki.
He's totally out of his mind! I'm gonna have to pose nude if this keeps up!
Just tell him you don't want to, sheesh.
How dare that, Yusuke!
The way he said it, it's not gonna be semi but full on nude.
You can report him for harassment.
Full nudity? Lady Yon's gonna...
Fa-fa-fa-fa-fa.
Drop it!
You know, you won't have to worry about that if we make Madarame confess before the exhibit ends.
Very true.
But Tagawa-kun thinks he owes his life to him. Is there a need to make Madarame confess?
Then, Lady Yon, you're fine with bearing it all?
I am not!
Madarame's no different from Kamoshida. That asshole's using Yusuke, who doesn't have parents. You're telling me we should just ignore how he's being treated horribly like the other pupils?
No. It is frustrating to leave this alone, even if Kitagawa-kun is fine with it himself.
You can't leave it be because you've endured a lot yourself with Kamoshida.
Yeah.
Anyways, we gotta go after this guy. Madarame is the kind of target we've been waiting for. Let's help Yusuke come to his senses, too.
Right.
Alright.
We need to look into Madarame first.
Whatever, man. I mean... whatever
goes,
goes.
Stuff that hasn't been exposed yet, too.
It may become easier for us to investigate his palace if he's preoccupied with his exhibit.
Also, there's the thing about me modeling. Kitagawa-kun said there'd be inconveniences unless he submits a new piece. Maybe that's going to be announced soon as Madarame's next work.
Does that mean the whole country's gonna see you nude?
Are you not confident?
What? Are you saying I'm... No, I mean... That's not what this is about!
We must deal with Madarame, no matter what, before his exhibit ends.
Let's start after school tomorrow.
I mean, hey, you're gonna become famous.
Oh, it'll be a pain if Miss President finds us on the rooftop again, so... where to meet up? Let's see...
Cafe.
I guess that walkway-like place in Shibuya would work. It's near Madarame's place, too.
Changing our hideout periodically, huh? That's a plan I don't mind backing.
Aww... Thought you guys would, you know, hang out at a cafe. Okay, Shujin Academy rooftop to Shibuya Teiku building accessway. Right.
Hey, can I talk to you kids for a sec?
Huh?
She has a camera.
From the looks of things, you don't seem like the ordinary stalking fans.
Dangerous. She has a camera.
Oh, sorry. I should have been more clear. I'm actually looking for people that know Madarame's pupils. There's this painting, Sayuri, that was supposedly stolen in the past. But there's this rumor that it was taken by one of his pupils in retaliation for being abused. Have you heard anything about that?
Ryuji knows.
Me? I don't know nothing.
I see. There's no case unless there's a victim, and if there's no proof of abuse, I can't write either.
Oh, so what are you, a journalist?
Looks like I'm back to square one. Sorry for taking your time. I'm a journalist. If you ever
right.
get any leads, mind contacting me here?
Sure.
See you then.
I guess we should go home for today.
Huh, whatever. I still can't forgive him, demanding to paint Lady Anne nude and then claiming to report us to the police. Well, I mean, we did, you know.
Hello?
Step into some of his private grounds. Hey, it's me, got a minute, I have some interesting news.
Actually...
Someone who received a change of heart contacted me on the fan site. Said he wants to meet with you to discuss another person who needs a change of heart. Why me though? You're better off talking to him in person if you want specifics. All I know is his target is a terrible person. Must be that guy. That might complicate things if he posted the name online. I'll have him wait for you at Shibuya Station after school. The guy's name is Nakanohara.
Hmm.
Nakanohara, huh? That's Madarame's student. I told him to approach you. Good luck.
Shapeshifter? Masquerade.
Alright. I found out something insane about Madarame. Sounds like a student of his offed himself when he couldn't speak up about Madarame stealing his work. Holy shit! Unforgivable! That journalist was looking into Madarame too. It could be real. Someone died though. No one's talking about it. I bet it was covered up. I wonder if Kitagawa-kun has heard anything. It'd be great if he could help us out. Ain't that asking a bit much? After today, he's probably gonna be on edge about us. Well, anyway, Madarame's still a piece of crap. Let's meet up tomorrow. It'll be our first time at the new hideout. It's that passageway in Shibuya, right? Got it. See you guys tomorrow. If the rumor Ryuji just spoke of is true, there have to be other victims. Well then. It's absolutely imperative that we win this one. Everyone slept today or what? God. How's the plan?
Oh.
Alright, let's do it. There are some reasonably priced nutrients. This ought to bring a better life back to this plant. This should up my kindness a little bit.
Alright.
Next up, a report of Mr. Kamoshida's acts of violence. This scandal has rocked the sports world. Everyone ever involved is blah blah blah.
Volleyball Association is currently considering banning him permanently and... drummed out of the Volleyball Association, eh? Well, he deserves it.
Hey. You should make sure your body gets enough rest. We're starting our plans tomorrow, you know?
Holy shit! How many days has it been since I got to go down? Jesus Christ, Kat. You're giving me all these bullshit reasons.
Well then.
Let's call it a day. Go to bed. Alright, what the fuck ever then. Seems like the percentage is going a little bit up again.
Well then.
Starting today, our new hideout is the Walkway in Shibuya. Speaking of Shibuya, then Mishima Sei Nakanohara would be there now too. Okay, let's go.
Yo.
We're about to head to the hideout too. Who's that? Excuse me. That's Nakanohara. Mishima told us to meet him here in Shibuya today. For real? My name is Nakanohara. Natsuhiko Nakanohara, the one who posted about on the Phantom Aficionado website. He seems pretty nice, doesn't seem like the stalker type. I think the change of heart must have worked. The administrator of the website contacted me. They told me to look for someone in Shujin uniform with a cat. So, what do you want? You may have already heard, but there's someone I wish to trigger a change of heart in. An artist by the name of Madarame.
Hey!
Do you think this is it? Is the pupil gonna confess his master's secrets? His shadow did mention Madarame as well. I'm one of Madarame's former pupils. He gave me lodging at his home where I taught only about art. I genuinely wanted to be an artist. There was another pupil as well, a very talented man, multiple years my senior. Obviously, Madarame kept tabs on him. Everything he made was claimed as Madarame's original. He wasn't the only victim though. Alright, we got some real proof of the plagiarism now. In response to Madarame's actions, that senior pupil committed suicide. Suicide. He must have been unable to bear seeing his work praised under Madarame's name. That was when I disobeyed Madarame's pleas and left. But he quickly pressured other parts of the art world and my life as a painter was destroyed. I tried to turn over a new leaf working at a ward office, but it was no use. My attachment to art warped my emotions, soon I began getting attached to everything. In the end, I even turned into a stalker. I'd like to ask again, please make Madarame have a change of heart. Not only for me, it's to save the life of another man as well. Save that life. Even now, there is still one young man remaining under Madarame's tutelage. I think he's about your age. That has to be Yusuke. Not only is he a talented artist, he also owes Madarame for taking him in after his mother passed. He is the perfect target, I suppose. So Yusuke's got no choice but to listen. I actually spoke to him a few times back when I was still living at Madarame's. I asked him if he found it painful to stay with Madarame. And do you know what he said? If I could leave, I would. Hidegawa-kun. Have no right to say this given my prior cowardice, but I don't want to see another suicide. I'd like to find a way to save this young man. He has a bright future ahead of him. Please consider that when thinking about changing Madarame's heart. Thank you. Have a good day. I'm going back to my low wage pay.
Hey.
Job. We've been asked to act directly on behalf of one of Madarame's victims. It sounds like we don't have the time to deliberate whether or not to change Madarame's heart. You're right. Oh yeah, Madarame's just a piece of shit, raised on a week. Suicide, I'll never let something like that happen. Plus, we finally got to hear how Kirigawa-kun really feels.
Okay.
Well, since we've reached an unanimous decision, how about we continue this at our new hideout?
My fellow thieves, welcome to our new hideout.
Well, this hideout sucks.
Our target this time is Madarame. We all saw that palace. We'll pay dearly if we assume it's just going to be like the last one. And furthermore, Lady An's chastity is on the line.
What?
We'll need to do what we did with Kamoshida. First, we secure an infiltration route in the palace. After that, we send our calling card. Once the treasure has materialized, we steal it.
Oh, I got a question. Madarame doesn't know that we were doing stuff in the palace yet. Why are we already getting treated like criminals in there?
You're learning, Ryuji. Well done.
Good point.
It must be because he doesn't trust anyone. Any unknown person may as well be an enemy.
Or maybe he's just super salty from all those rumors that have been spreading about him.
Then his palace being so crazy had nothing to do with us?
Either way, we should stay on our best behavior. It'll be harder for us to steal the treasure if we needlessly increase the security level.
We need to be careful of Kitagawa-kun this time, too. I'm sure that whatever he sees will just get passed on to Madarame.
That's right.
Hey, what is Madarame's treasure going to look like anyway? Another crown?
I doubt that.
Probably a painting.
But my sixth sense will know when I see it.
Oh yeah, you go completely nuts, huh?
Our time limit is when the exhibit ends, right? That means June 5th.
No, that's pretty fucking far away. God damn, that's like 17 days?
We'll carry out the plan after we've sent out the calling card. So our infiltration route will need to be set in stone 2 days prior, on June 2nd.
Now listen here! We can't mess this up, no matter what! Okay?
Or maybe I will, just so I can see you nude. No, I'm kidding. Alright, let's go fucking do it.
Okay.
This is the first job for Ephemerality, so let's make sure we do it right. Come on, it's time to get this mission started. The mission to change Madarame's heart has begun. You must steal his treasure by the deadline. 18 days, huh? Occasionally, you will encounter palace obstacles that are impossible and require interacting with the target in the real world. You'll need to leave the palace to find the obstruction and enter palaces quickly to find obstacles and triumph over challenges before the deadline. Understood. Any requests we have today? No. Nada. Alright, let's hold a meeting.
Well,
if we change the heart of someone famous, people have to believe in us. This is our first job as Phantom Thieves. Let's stay calm and act deliberately.
Okay, time for the meeting.
We don't know anything about it yet, so I guess we should investigate some more. I think we'll be able to come up with a countermeasure that way. What do we want to do about the shadows? It'd be real bad if any of them caught us. Think we should try avoiding them for now or something? They're all fighting relatively well at this point. Our team is steadily getting stronger.
That's
about
the meeting.
Size of it. Go in.
Okay, let's go.
Let's fucking kick ass.
Now then.
I'm sure you already know this, but the first thing we need to do is secure an infiltration route. Then we send a calling card. Yeah, we know the drill. Anyway, let's get ready. So, we're gonna do it in the next part. Hell fucking yeah. Can I actually get help from the Thieves Guild now, or?
Focus.
Oh yeah, I can combine personas.
I can feel it.
Alright, so, yeah. In the next part, we're gonna, explore more of this whole Madarame's museum palace thingy, and yeah, gonna fucking steal his heart and beat the shit out of him just like we did Kamoshida. So, thanks everyone for watching. Check the annotation to the end for more games that I've played before, and I'll see you guys in the next part of Persona 5. Stay frosty, y'all.